Waiguru's head is being asked for, not by the county assembly. I can tell you, and I have the evidence, the people who are looking for Waiguru's head is not the
point
county
of order,
assembly.
Mr. Speaker. Point of order, Mr. Speaker.
And Mr. Speaker.
Point of order, Mr. Speaker. Point of order, Mr. Speaker. Point of order, Mr. Speaker. Point of order, Mr. Speaker. The people of Kirinyaga have all along the week suspected that, Mr. Speaker, there is a decision already made elsewhere to form a committee to save Waiguru.
No, no, order.
Then Senator Orengo goes public, Mr. Speaker. To confirm.
Order.
Senator Orengo goes on record to confirm that a decision has already been made, Mr. Speaker.
Order, Senator.
So if this committee is going to sanitize Waiguru, you tell us the truth.
Wow.
You literally had to feed it down because it was just...
Yeah, but they were talking about someone's head.
Yeah, off with her head.
This was another low point, I think, for the Senate. You know, there are many people who thought for a very long time the Senate had distinguished itself as this house where there were very substantive debates that were a lot more sober than what was happening across the street at the National Assembly. But lately, those kinds of shouting matches have become quite the hallmark of the Senate, Francis. But this idea of the head, what was that that was going on between Orengo and Murkomen?
Nothing unusual. Same handshake versus others. We saw it during the Waititu situation. We saw it during the Kindiki situation. And so this is the third match, so to say. But there was a small match, a mini match, about a vote on the extension of time for the Senate sitting.
Yeah.
A pretty simple matter, but I remember having a conversation with, with Linus at that point. It was a dress rehearsal for the big vote. The big vote on whether to go select committee or to go to the plenary.
And I want to stop you right there.
Yeah.
So that, first of all, take us through this whole process, what we expected, because we're going to do a lot about the politics as we go. But that was a vote on whether to extend. But then there is a whole process about how then this proceeds from here.
Because there was the
big debate about committee versus
plenary,
whole house and whatever. And I know Yvonne did quite a bit of that, but that was a very high stakes affair. Because there is a reason. If it goes to the committee, it dies faster, potentially.
Absolutely. And what the CIA senator and minority leader in the Senate was simply saying, he simply meant that the whole discussion around the governor's impeachment has very, very little to do with Kirinyaga County Assembly, but other attendant political issues. You know, look at the political environment in the country. And when he said, somebody is looking for the governor's head, I interpreted it to mean that those who, in their estimation, are pushing for the governor's impeachment, if she's successfully impeached, then it will be a victory for the Tanga Tanga team. That's the impression that was created in the Senate. And that's where you realized immediately, the moment he said that, the first point of order came from the Elgeyo Marakwet senator and immediate former majority leader in the Senate. And there has been a perception that if the matter was to go to a select committee, it is a simple way of saving the governor from impeachment. Because all she needs is 6 out of 11 senators to support her in the committee. And Section 33(6)(b) of the County Governments Act says, if any of the allegations are not substantiated at the committee level, that matter dies there. Mm. If any of the allegations are substantiated, then her fate will be determined by the Senate in a plenary session. And so the easier way to avoid that plenary session is to, quote unquote, kill the matter at the committee level. And that was the whole tug of war between...
And the House then has no recourse.
Yes.
They cannot recall it.
No.
The committee
the
said, guess what, we went there, we looked into those things,
there's
really
nothing
there.
But finally, you see, a plenary session, a trial by plenary, it's like a public trial, so to say.
Yeah.
So people will say quite a number of things, all manner of things. And remember, parliamentarians have this immunity in the House. They can say quite a number of things about you, And there's very little that you can do. You can do nothing. They'll say very many things about you. You may actually win and save your job, but a number of things will have been said that are fundamentally critical in the public purview. People will always look at you as, wewe, Senate ilisema hivi. Even if you escaped that, but this is what was said about you in the Senate. And it will remain in the Hansard forever and ever.
But the dynamics were interesting, Linus, just looking at how that thing played out. We saw, for example, senators who the previous time, when it was Waititu's time, for example, they were pushing to have this matter in the committee. Now this time they were actually pushing for it to be done in plenary. People taking very different positions depending on what we are talking about or who we are talking about.
Yeah, the dynamics...